Hello, so good to meet you at this global motivational meeting. We are reading one scripture book to inspire and empower a positive vibe for the day. This holy book are helping billions of people, families, communities, countries, and the whole world, and will help you to just read these quotes and practice daily. As we read this holy book from the beginning, please find all the chapters in our message to billion channel. And now we are reading about qualities for happy and prosperous life. Let's read further about universal love. True love is universal. It has no limits. When we are immersed in the love of God, we can experience that everyone is our brother or sister. Here is a major distinction between absolute true love and the relative love of fallen people. True love is impartial and universal. While fallen love is partial to kith and kin, to friends and compassion. Compatriots. In the words of Martin Luther King Jr., any adult has not started living until he has risen above the narrow confines of his individualistic concepts to the broader concept concerns of all humanity. Yet, is love for humanity enough? No. If we mean only a general sentiment that and satisfied by acts of charity and the political effort to benefit the downtrodden, the real stage of love is actual relationships. How can we love strangers and people of faraway nations with the same intensity and concreteness as we love members of our family? Here, scripture speaks of extending to strangers the way we treat members of our own family. Father Moon is very clear on this score. To demonstrate universal love, the transcend race, he recommends that we give one of our children in marriage to someone of another race. By digesting every difficulty in relating to our own in-laws, we became people whose love truly goes beyond the racial barrier, a heart of to love all people. May good befall all, may there be peace for all, may be fit for perfection, and may all experience that which is auspicious. Oh, may all be happy, may all be healthy, may we all experience what is good, and let no one suffer. Om, peace, peace, peace. The sage has no fixed personal ideas. He regards the people's ideas of his own. I treat those who are good with goodness, and I also treat those who are not good with goodness. Thus, goodness is attained. I am honest with those who are honest, and I am also honest with those who are dishonest. Thus, honesty is attained. Further, let's read quotes from the second coming Messiah, Father Sun and Moon. The sages of old taught us to love heaven, to love the earth, and to love humankind. God's love is the original source of the universe, and it embraces the world. If such love had reached each and every person, wouldn't this world be a realm where love is everywhere? Wherever we go, up or down, in such a world, what would we value in a person? It would not be eloquence or good looks. We would value people of character, those who are fit, faultless from any angle. Their fragrance would spread to everyone who knew them. Shouldn't you be like that when you relate to others with the heart that each is a part of God and no one is unrelated to God? Then everyone becomes your friend. A loving heart is the same wherever it is for an enemy or for a friend. It is universal. The whole is the same as one cell. The universe is formed like a human being, each composed of 400 trillion cells living in oneness. you can become one with God when you became the embodiment of love that can connect to all of this self. God's love has no boundaries. Love transcends national boundaries. Love transcends race and love. There is no discrimination between black and white and yellow. Love is the greatest thing. Whenever love flows freely and without fear, the environment adapts it to it. Who or what would want to rebel? This way of thinking is pleasing to God. Distributing love everywhere is the only way to win God's favor. What is the character of God? God is a being who loves his object partner more than he loves himself. God's activity of loving the object partner more than self bring unity. Then together they can love an object partner of a greater scope. Since this is the core of God's practice, God sends the person closest to himself to the evil world, offering him as a sacrifice for humankind. This is God's way of thinking. That is why the sages, saints, and the great men of history invariably thought love all humankind. They did not restrict their love to only their family, but loved their country. They went beyond their country to love the world. They loved this way even though they were not welcomed, but rejected and sacrificed. So powerful quotes for today. If you have difficulties, please watch one more time this video. Share this as we end this billion happy life subscribers marathon. Contact me for consultation, cooperation, and be a member of this Heavenly Parents Holy Community globally. Wish you a great, blessed, happy day, and stay happy, healthy. Don't forget to make morning exercise in this difficult time. And see you tomorrow with more powerful quotes. Yours, Coach Nikolai Servala. Bye-bye for now.